Welcome to Easy Learning Economics. This is Dr. Cavill. Today our topic is Law of Equi-Marginal Utility. In this lecture, we will talk about the Law of Equi-Marginal Utility, assumptions of this law, and the limitations of this law, and how does the Law of Equi-Marginal Utility is having importance in our practical life. So first of all, we start with the law of equi-marginal utility. That what is law of equi-marginal utility? Law of equi-marginal utility was presented in 19th century by an Australian economist, H.H. Gossin. It is also known as the law of maximum satisfaction, or law of substitution, or Gossin's second law. A consumer has a number of wants. He tries to spend limited income on different things in such a way that marginal utility of all things is equal. So, law of equi-marginal utility is basically a utility analysis. How can we define the law of equi-marginal utility? So, the law states that consumer gets maximum level of satisfaction by substituting the commodities when he spends all of his income on the purchase of goods in such a way that the consumer gets the same marginal utility from the last rupee spent on each commodity. So, this law can be rewrite as the marginal utility of a commodity divided by price of A is equal to marginal utility of B divided by price of B is equal to marginal utility of N divided by price of N, the number of the lot of units. What are these assumptions on the basis of which this law can function? The consumer is rational with unlimited wants. So it means the consumer has unlimited wants and limited resources or scarce resources, and consumer wants to get maximum satisfaction by substituting and dividing the commodities with perfect knowledge of utility. Consumer has limited income and has to spend whole income on the purchase of commodity. Cardinal approach is used, and law of diminishing marginal utility also applies in case of law of equi-marginal utility. Price of commodities remains constant. Utility of money is constant. So these are the assumptions on the basis of which the law of equi-marginal utility functions. So now we are talking about the table and graph showing the equi-marginal utility. So this is the table which shows that the units and marginal utility from bananas and marginal utility from oranges. So this table demonstrates that by consuming the first unit of banana, the consumer marginal utility is 5, and the marginal utility from oranges is 4, whereas the marginal utility from the second banana is 4 and marginal utility from second orange is 3. The marginal utility from third banana is 3 and marginal utility from third orange is 2, whereas the marginal utility from fourth banana is 2 and marginal utility from fourth orange is 1 and marginal utility from fifth banana is 1 and marginal utility from fifth orange is -1. So which choice is good for consumer? It is assumed that the price of both goods is 2 rupees per unit. So it is assumed that the price for the one banana is 2 rupees and price for one orange is 2 rupees. So which combination is good for consumer, where he gets the maximum level of satisfaction in rupees 10? So the best choice is 3-3. However, consumer equilibrium condition is satisfied here and here, because the marginal utility is 4 and marginal utility is 4 and marginal utility is 2-2. But which situation is better for consumer, because the consumer has 10 rupees? So the best choice for the consumer is by consuming the 3 bananas by spending his 6 rupees. It means the consumer spend is 6 rupees on the banana, whereas the 2 units of oranges, where on 2 units of oranges the consumer spent 4 rupees. So it means that 10 rupees are totally spent and nothing is left on the part of the consumer, and the consumer is getting maximum satisfaction 3-3. The marginal utility is same. This is the first condition of this law. So, however, the marginal utility is same 4-4 by purchasing the one orange, it means whereby he gets 4 units of level of satisfaction. It means he is spending only 2 rupees, and on bananas he is spending 4 rupees. So he is saving 4 rupees. So this is against the law. So this position is not good for the consumer. And if we talk about this, that the 2-2, it means at this position the consumer is spending 4 rupees on oranges and 4 rupees on banana. So this situation is not good. So the best situation is that the consumer can maximize its level of satisfaction by spending 6 rupees purchasing 3 units of banana and 4 rupees on purchase of oranges. So whole amount of the 10 rupees is being consumed by the consumer. Shaded portion shows that the good point for the consumer equilibrium. This table can be converted into a graph. Here you can see that this is the marginal utility from banana. With the first unit of a banana, the marginal utility is 5, and with the second unit of banana, the marginal utility is 4, and with the third unit of banana, the marginal utility is 3, and with the fourth unit of banana, the marginal utility is 2, and by eating the fifth banana, the marginal utility is 1. And likewise, the other table, which shows the marginal utility from oranges, dotted red line is showing that the consumer is in equilibrium with 3 units of banana and 2 units of oranges. The utility from banana as well as from oranges is 3. So consumer is said to be in equilibrium and gets optimum level of satisfaction. What are the limitations of law of equi-marginal utility, or what are the weakness of this law? This law fails to consider the optimum point of equal marginal utility in case the goods are not divisible, like if the goods are car and they can't be divided, like bananas and oranges. So this law fails to consider the equal marginal utility in case of the goods which are indivisible goods. This law does not consider the marginal utility on the basis of habit, taste and fashion. Difficult to compare the marginal utility of durable goods with perishable goods. And the assumptions which we have assumed in this law that might not be true, like cardinal approach is used, as utility can't be measured cardinally. So what is the practical importance of law of equi-marginal utility? How does it is beneficial? This law tells us how to manage the scarce resources to satisfy unlimited wants. And it guides the producer to use the factor of production with high marginal utility. It helps the consumer to buy the goods with greater marginal utility. So this law is also the base for theory of production and theory of distribution. So it tells that what to produce, where to produce, and how to produce, and for whom to produce. And theory of distributions, that how much must be allocated to the land, labor, capital. So this law also functions important. So thank you very much for watching. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel and press bell icon.